I'm Doug, and welcome to Doppler's Gear Garage, where we've got the inaugural episode of Must Own Gear. And today we are checking out the Fender Player Plus Telecaster. This guitar is amazing. It's great for rhythm. It's great for lead. Everything that I love about Telecasters, it does, and more. And if you've never owned a Tele, this is a great place to start. But in a moment, we're going to go through the key features. But before we do that, I want to let you know that down below in the show notes, you're going to find timeline links for each of the chapters in this video. You're also going to find the description of this guitar as well. And you're also going to find some affiliate links from Sweetwater for this instrument and the backline gear that I'm using for the demos. That said, let's get to the key features. So the thing about this guitar is it's got great assets. And it's not just that it's designed well and it's got all the right parts. Everything works together exceptionally well. It's just a workhorse of an instrument. Really, of all the guitars that I own, it's pretty much right at the top of the class in terms of being able to do the widest range of things with excellence. All right, so kind of from the top down, you have some locking tuners. You have basically this great modern C-shaped neck. What's really neat is that kind of, if you think of this as the shoulder of the neck, when it's a larger neck, when I do the Hendrix thing, my thumb comes around, there are certain things I can't do with bends playing the pentatonic. So the shape of this neck is really comfortable for being able to do the Jimmy thing and being able to, if you will, kind of shred a little bit with the pentatonic, if that makes sense. The 12 degree radius is awesome. And what it means is up at the top of the neck, it still kind of has a vintagey feel, but it means it doesn't fret out when you bend. My very first guitar, electric guitar, I should say, was a Jaguar. And that guitar, just the top of the neck, it just fretted out continuously. Loved the guitar, didn't love the way it fretted out. All right, these pickups are the brand new Noiseless pickups that they put together for the Player Plus line, and they are amazing. Traditional three-way switch here. Hang on, there we go, three-way switch. But what you've got here is what I would call a pull-push. I don't know why they call it push-pull, because really you pull it up and you push it back down. In any case, that pull-push control there, regardless of which position you're in, basically gives you both pickups in series versus the middle position when that's down. That's both pickups in parallel. And you'll get a chance to hear that in the demos. What's neat about it is it's got this nice little contour here. Super comfortable to play. Six individual saddles, which means it intonates really well. And again, above and beyond all things, it plays and sounds great. All right, we're going to go through a range of demos demonstrating the things that it does. So let's get to it. So this first demo is going to allow us to hear the bridge, middle, neck, and then both pickups in series. So you can hear them all back to back over this little progression that you heard at the top. And then I'm going to go up to the top of the neck with the guitar still in series mode. Normally, but not for this demo, when I'm toggling between sounds and not changing a preset or stepping on a stomp or something, in the bridge position on this guitar, I had a tendency to back off by about 25% or so, depending. And the pickups and the way the tone controls are set, it really does that really well. I'm not doing that in this demo, but just the balance of these pickups to do what I'm about to do, toggling between those sounds without adjusting the tone control, it's pretty amazing to be able to do that. Let's take a listen. Thank you. normally when I think of medium to high gain rhythm guitar tones in the bridge position, Telecaster is not the first guitar that comes to mind. Normally there's just kind of a brightness that makes it a little bit too bright. But the way these pickups are wound and the way they interact with the tone control, you can take a sound like I've got dialed up on my GT1000, and as you back off the tone control, it goes from being modern to kind of vintage. The preset is actually utilizing two different amps panned left and right, and I absolutely loved this sound. Moving over to the middle position, now you're going to hear the guitar coming out of the Tone Master Super Reverb, which I can almost guarantee you will be making its own appearance on Must Own Gear very soon. Moving over to the neck pickup, you're also going to hear a little bit of the Fender Mirror Image Delay going into the Tone Master Deluxe Reverb. Moving back to the middle position, now we're going to come out of the Mustang GTX 100, which by the way is a total sleeper amplifier. It's got a ton of great tones and effects in it. Coming out in stereo, this one's kind of inspired by the Edge, so for any of the P-Dub people out there, this will probably give you a pretty good idea of how well this guitar will do in the House of Worship. The last box I wanted to check on the demo front was this guitar in the bridge position for some distorted lead tones. I'm going to take the same distorted preset you heard before on the GT1000 core and add a little bit of delay, and I'm going to play over the backing track which you also heard before. Before we get to that, I want to say thank you so much for checking out this video, and again, if you haven't already subscribed to the channel, would love to invite you to do so. Please don't forget to ring the bell so I can let you know the next time a Must Own Gear video goes online. Until then, thanks again for watching. Cheers.